Wait, did I just get rugged by the French? LVT? I thought that project was dead.
If your routine's like mine, unfortunately, you have to sprinkle these little rug scans throughout your day. And I mean, like, I'm in like 50 different projects, so I'm not trolling, you know, Discord and Twitter all day either. And I mean, when I'm stuck in a project that hasn't moved in months, I'm really not checking very often. So I was actually pretty excited to see some signal of life on the Louverture chart earlier today. I actually invested like $1,500 into this project back on, I think it was December 23rd, right before Christmas. I remember I was on, you know, the beginning of my Christmas break, and I was just kind of bored and I wanted to get involved, and I kind of spur of the moment just sort of like FOMO'd in to LVT. And then a couple of days later, they cut their rewards. Like when I got in, it was like 7% rewards. And then almost immediately, I'm horrible at timing. Almost immediately after that, they cut their rewards. So I went from, you know, whatever that number comes out to be, like $5,100 today per day calculation, to like $4 per day in returns. So I was like, man, this really sucks. Thanks, crypto. I mean, I liked what the team was building, and that's kind of why I got into it in the first place. It's just that I made that decision based on when my break even was supposed to be. And that's how I calculated my risk, right? So when it was just immediately, you know, cut dramatically, I was super bummed out about it. So I had really just come to the terms of like, look, I'm going to try and, you know, compound just continuously. And then maybe by the time I'm like 80, 85, I'll be able to use the rewards from LVT to fund like my nursing home that I live in. So I really just pushed it to the side. And then I'm doing my daily rug scan, and I came across this chart, and I was like, oh, look, something happened. I had read previously on their Discord that they had a problem with a developer that kind of went rogue and had held up or had access to the wallet and had, you know, basically stolen from the project, and they were having a hard time recovering from that because, you know, I guess they didn't have multi-sig in place or whatever the case was. So I had really kind of just written this project off, and then I pushed it to the side. They said that they were going to try to do some things about it. I was like, whatever, I'm focused on other projects now. So it looks like this action that happened today, it is not a rug pull. It's not due. It's not that rogue developer stealing anything. This is the legitimate LVT team's response to correcting what that rogue developer had done. And I'll kind of break that down a little bit in just a second. So first of all, like over in their Discord, you know, you can see, you go all the way back to February 1st and just scroll through their announcements. You know, these guys are active. They are staying engaged. They're building in the background. And I think that's cool. Even though like their price action has been total garbage, and they've had these problems. I mean, so does every other crypto project. So it's how they handle it and then what they do for their investors. I think like longer term and how they're able to maintain and continue to build trust, that's really important. So I love seeing all this communication in their Discord, even though I haven't really been in here and following it, you know, until I look and I see this like giant red candle on my chart. I'm looking and, you know, the first place that I come is the latest announcement, and I see the communication here that says stop, you know, breathe and read, right? So I know that this isn't a rug pull right off the bat. Plus like the perfect time for this, for these people to have rugged would have been like way back when they cut the rewards. But so I'm looking at this and I see, okay, they've put out some communication about this. Awesome. They gave a great summary for what's happening. And essentially, they're saying that they are migrating to a version 2 contract so that they can completely separate their project from what that rogue developer had access to initially. And I think that's really important. So this is the overall summary. They've taken a snapshot. You don't need to do anything. You just need to sit back and wait for the version 2 contract to be to go live, and then they will be facilitating the migration from version 1 to version 2. So you'll know, you know, if there is any action needed at that point. But everything is sort of frozen in time right now. No action required by anybody that has LVT tokens right now. So they also put out a Medium article, which was really informative and kind of broke everything down. So if I go to the Medium article, some of the same language that they posted over in the Discord channel, and then this really explains the red candle. So we drain the liquidity. We drain the liquidity. They shorted their entire LVT holdings against the LVT AVAX pair in an attempt to reclaim as much AVAX as possible from the liquidity pool. And you know, they talk about why they can't use the version 1 token. And it talks about the rogue developer that I mentioned, and they don't have control over that contract. So an upgrade's out of the question. New contract, new token coming down the pipeline right now. And they also mentioned that the liquidity is locked for 5 years. So the only way to reclaim the liquidity is by swapping against the pair. And what that looks like and the way it presents itself is a giant red candle because it's a sell order. So so they're explaining that right here. And I think this is great. So they want to provide launch liquidity to the new trading pair. So they're going to use the reclaimed AVAX to provide liquidity for the new pair and aim to match the price at which they liquidated the holdings. So they've taken all the snapshots and done everything that they need to do in order to be able to line that up. So they're discouraging the trading of the token. As we do not have ownership of the contract, we unfortunately cannot stop trading of the token. We fully intend to crash the price. Well done, Louverture. And so that it would discourage any further trading of the token. So the legacy version 1 token no longer carries any intrinsic value. They're completely migrating to the new contract. So, and it says, we stop paying rewards. Yes, they stop paying rewards. Like, where are the rewards going to come from, guys? So we just have to wait until the version 2 token is released. So, and they also mention again that their intention is to discourage the community from engaging in the protocol until everything is migrated. I think you guys did that by, you know, the giant red candle. So it definitely got my attention. So if you're new to crypto, crap like this happens all the time. So I consider myself new to crypto, and like I'm almost like numb to this now. So so just the communication is super important. I think they're doing a great job with that. So, you know, my advice to anybody else that's invested in Louverture right now is just to go into the Discord, track what's going on, track their updates and announcements, and then at some point they're going to release an announcement that says our version 2 contract is live. You know, if there is some action that you need to take in order to migrate your version 1 tokens, like in your wallet, over to version 2, most of you have seen the mechanism that gets put in place in dApps to be able to do that. They'll have something similar. So you'll be able to, you know, take whatever you have in MetaMask or in your ledger or whatever device in your wallet and convert that over to the version 2 contract. So it looked like it was horrible, not a horrible thing. I think this is probably the best way that they could handle a situation like this. You know, in the future, maybe they take additional precautions around you know, multi-sig and other security procedures or security precautions. But for where the project is now and based on what happened already, I think this is a good response. I want to know what you all think, though. And listen, so guys, my channel is like tiny, like Putin's peepee. So if you don't mind, subscribe and like.
Shouldn't have said that.
So we get some traction on the channel. And that would help me, you know, help me kind of be motivated to create more videos and put more information out there. If you're invested in LVT, I'm curious to hear what you think about the way they're handling this migration and just like how you feel about the project in general. So drop a comment below and let me know.